With all the forms complete, the only remaining steps to completing this inner lamp shape is to install a fabricated part, which is the lamp post. So if we go into our lamp project and open up our stock parts, the lamp posts would get installed, and then the outer arm here, the skin, would get installed as well. So this would again be an oversized part that would be trimmed all the way around, and you could then with a router just use the existing part to help trim this thinner sheet as it gets formed. Once the lamp post gets installed and the wiring gets put into the channel, we could install the outer arm, and we could use the same tooling that we already have, like the main inner form and the main outer form, to help guide putting that on. But we could then retrim that top surface using the router just running along the outer edge of this part. Once everything gets trimmed to size, then the only thing that remains is to attach the arm base. And this arm base here, we can hide some of our components, like our tooling. And the only thing that would be required is to key these two components together. For example, we could go back to our original body. If we move everything together back up to this feature, we could then add a feature to this body here by using the feature that exists on this part. So I can take a new sketch on this surface, and I can again project some more geometry to that. I'm going to just select these outer edges, and we can extrude some more geometry here to extend up past this surface. We're just going to union this. We're going to go adjust this union by coming to this element, and I'm going to change the target bodies again to exclude these two and include this one. Now these are connected together, and I can trim this tool here using the lamp body itself. So I'm going to do a split body, and I'm going to delete this section here that's on top. So now with this tool complete, we can also use the features of it to help install this component onto the lamp itself.